I feel, I got something in me. Holy Ghost powers in me right now. Yesterday, Saturday. How many people yesterday? You know what Saturday? Back in the day, we would get Saturday, and we're glad to get Saturday. Yesterday, I'm like, I'll be glad when Saturday's over. I can't wait to get to Sunday. I'm saying I wouldn't hurt to go to bed and go to sleep so I can get in here on Sunday, because there's some power that's got to be released from God to us. Holy Ghost power. Hit praise. Oh, okay, all right. Periscope, Holy Ghost power. Now, let me tell you how Satan is upset with me. Y'all, God love this ministry. I'll tell you something. Yeah. Laugh all out. You laugh the whole service. The joy of the Lord. Come on here. The joy of the Lord. I love it when you start laughing up in here. Man, we've had people come here and laugh for 2 or 3 hours nonstop. Oh, y'all haven't seen trances yet, have you? We have people sitting in a trance. Minimum on 3 or 4 hours, right? And didn't move anything. In a trance. Come on, let me hear. Just like Azusa Street. In a trance. My God. You had young people in trances up in here. Male and female. Old and young. Because the power of God hit them. And they went to heaven somewhere and saw some stuff. I'll tell you what they saw too. This is a supernatural house. Supernatural medical center. But he's angry with me. Let's start with this. When I went to the barber shop on Thursday, I believe, the preacher that cuts my hair is a preacher. The owner of the barber shop is a preacher. They preaching here before. Both of them. And they cut right around the corner right here in Clinton, Maryland. So the owner, father, he'll be cutting your hair and talking the Bible all the time you're cutting your hair. They don't play none of gospel music up in there. Amen. Gospel music the whole time you're there. Amen. Come on, that's my kind of barber shop. So as the preacher was cutting my hair, he said, Pastor, tonight when we go to church, a young man in our church, 14 years old, had a severe asthma attack. I hate asthma with a passion. Keep on laughing. I love it. He had an asthma attack. 14 years old. Church up the street from us. Baptist church up the street. That's right. Right here. So he said the whole church would be praying for him tonight. They said they took him to, I believe they took him to Southern Maryland. But it was so serious, they had to medevac him to Children's Hospital in D.C. So took him to Children's Hospital. And he started having seizures. Then something happened with his heart from the stuff. Went into a coma. So he goes into a coma, 14 years old. Now this just a few days ago. Now get this. So I said, preacher, I'll tell you what you do tonight. I said, when you get to your church tonight, you stand on Psalm 107 and 20. Yes. He sent his word. Yes. I said, even though you won't be in the hospital room, the word is Jesus. He is the living word. Yes. Supernatural word is alive.
Yes.
You can be right here and send it to Africa if you want to. Send it to the Bahamas. Send it to Switzerland, France, Italy, anywhere you want to send it. So you send it. Psalm 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. So I said, you take that and give it to your pastor. Now get this. He was in a coma, right? Well, the next day, which was Friday, I believe, no, Thursday, I get a phone call. Because I went I get a phone call from another barber from the same barber shop. He said, Pastor, at 3 p.m. today, I got a call about 2:45. He said, 3 p.m. today, the church want everybody praying for the boy. At 3 p.m. today, everybody will be praying for him. He said that he woke up from the coma. He came out of the coma. Hear me? Now, I'm saying why Satan hates my guts. So he came up out of the coma. So it's at 3 o'clock praying for him because now they're saying that he's going to be brain dead. Because the oxygen can't get to his brain. I said, what? 14 years old? Well, Satan is wicked. Satan is evil. He's a destroyer. He cometh not but to do what? Kill, steal, and destroy. This is a 14-year-old. He's trying to destroy a 14-year-old and his family with it. So, I said, 3 o'clock, here's what you do. I said, read Matthew 10:1 out loud. When he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power. What kind of power?
Holy Ghost power.
He gave them power against who? Unclean spirits. To do what with them? Talk to them? To cast them out. And to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Now I said, you take your fingers, because he don't know nothing about this. I said, after you read that Matthew 10:1, live. Words that I speak to you, spirit and life. Now, guess what, y'all? I get a phone call yesterday from Evangelist Tawana Holt. She said, Pastor, I gotta ask you a question. She said that Miracle, her daughter called her. And Miracle, preacher, come on in the house. Come on in the house. Make a compliment, Minister Lauren. Make a compliment, Minister Lauren. Come on, Pastor.
God bless you, Pastor.
Now, he said, Pastor Ron, it's good to see you. She's a pastor. Licensed and ordained as any death card. I love it. Now, I get that call from Evangelist Tawana Holt. She said, Pastor, I got to ask you a question. She said, Miracle called me. Now, Miracle, she said, Miracle was with a girlfriend of hers, and they was with the girl's brother who has asthma. In the hospital. She said, I prayed for him and he died. She said, he died. She said that Miracle was with a friend of hers who had a young brother, had asthma attack, was in a coma, and now he's dead. I said, hold up here. I wonder if it's the same kid. I said, I asked a few questions, but she couldn't, you know, answer because all she did was pray for him. I said, hold on. This sounds too much like what I'm dealing with. So I said, I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to make one phone call. I'm going to call that preacher at the barbershop. I said, I'll call you back. So I called Mr. Cedric. I said, Minister, that little boy that had an asthma, is he alive? He said, no, Pastor, he's dead. I knew then. He said, no, Pastor, he's dead. 14 years old. He died Thursday night. Say he killed him. He said, he's dead. I said, well, I said, one of my preachers, the daughter's a friend of theirs. She didn't want to tell me that the kid was dead. I want to see it was the same kid. Same kid. Got me? So the little boy's dead from asthma. So right then and there, I said to myself, Ms. Loma, give me an asthma apparatus, please. Okay, right then and there. I've underestimated this demon. See, I've always thought that he was just a breathing problem. But he's a murderer. He can kill. This punk can kill. I thought, you know, you get dizzy, blow a little bit, you know what I'm saying? And you got trouble breathing. He's a murderer. So that means that we're going to have to fight him like the low-down, dirty dog that he is. Please talk to me in the warrior. Yes, he is. Seriously, we got to declare war against this asthma devil like we do cancer, like we do sugar diabetes, yes. Like we do kidney failure, dialysis machines. We got to war because he murdered that child. So let me tell you about spiritual warfare. Satan know who you are.
A.R. Bernard.
A.R. Bernard. In New York, yes.
His son died in the sleep.
Stop right there, Ms. Lund. Y'all hear that? You tell me that Pastor A.R. Bernard, the largest pastor in New York City, his son died in the same crap.
In his sleep.
In his sleep.
He's only 39
years old. A.R. Bernard is big. A lot of celebrities at his great big church in Brooklyn, a man, wherever he is, Brooklyn, I believe. His son died in his sleep. Killed a pastor's son, event, pastor. Uh-oh. People have gotten healed of asthma in this camp. Multiple people. Multiple. Young and old, middle aged, old, young children have come to him and been, oh God. Totally healed of asthma in here. Oh, hold on. And Miss Lama, get a mic and come over here because that's a good one. Get everybody come over here, Miss Lawn. Patrick's son. I like Patrick. Patrick is from the same country as Miss Lawn's from, South America. You hear me? And Patrick is a very smart guy. He graduated from Howard University too, didn't he? You know, got his own business. Tell him about his son.
His son was born with asthma.
Born with it?
Mm-hmm. Real bad, to the point he could not play. Couldn't even run. And he brought him in here one night, about 6-7 years ago. And Pastor prayed for him. As a matter of fact, he had the...
He had one of these?
He had that, and he had...
And then that bigger thing.
The plastic.
Yeah.
What they call it, a nebulizer?
A nebulizer?
Yeah, he had that too.
Oh, that's serious.
Yeah, he could not run. He could not play outside.
Hold on, stop right there.
Mm-hmm.
This demon is shutting children down from playing.
Yeah.
A child has to play.
Yeah. No.
Or that child will get depressed early in life.
Mm-hmm.
He can't run outside like normal children. He couldn't.
Right. Brought him here one time.
Is that on?
Yeah, it is on.
Okay.
He brought him here one time. And Pastor prayed for him. And he has not used a nebulizer since or has had no symptoms of asthma.
One of your best friends. Completely healed of asthma. One trip here.
One time. Yeah.
One time.
And
oh my God.
He was healed. Yeah, he had it real bad.
He had it real bad. And Patrick's son. Hallelujah. Thank you, Ms. Lawn. How old was Patrick's son, Ms. Lawn? Around what age?
Should be about 13 now.
My God.
But he had it from birth.
Had it from birth. Another one that came here, a Caucasian kid from Southern Maryland, Catholic, from the Catholic Church, heard about the power of God in here. The boy had it so bad, never forget his name, Philip is his name, he was 12 years old. Philip had asthma so bad. You know what kind of torment it is if you lay down in your bed and you got to hook an oxygen tank up to you? Every night you go to sleep. An oxygen tank. He couldn't go to bed without an oxygen tank. He had a room full of oxygen tanks, some empty, some full. And then they pull up in their truck from the hospital, exchange, take the empty, and give him another one. Brought him in here, the Catholic mother. God healed Philip instantly in here. He never used this again. And guess what? The hospital had to come and take all the oxygen tanks out of the house and didn't need it no more. What's his name? What's his name?
Jesus.
What's his name?
Jesus.
He's a healer.
Amen.
I don't care what people say. I'm always going to be bold about this healer.
That's right.
That's right. So I told evangelists, the ones I'm going to teach y'all, preachers, especially y'all, and I'm teaching something right now. She said, Pastor, I don't know what to tell her because she asked me, you prayed for him to be healed, and he died. So Pastor, what do I tell her? I said, here's what you tell her. I'm going to tell y'all. Your job is to pray. Your job is to war and to declare life. It's not your job whether they live or die. You got nothing to do with that. That's not in your power. You work for Jesus. He's the healer, not us. No man has healing power. No man, or the Bible said, no man can do these things except he do them by God. Except God be with him, it's all going to come to nothing. You hear me? So when you pray for somebody, don't you be in there, folks ain't dying, folks down. That's not your problem. That's not your problem is in the name of Jesus. I bind up this sickness, I bind up this disease, I rebuke death on you. Arise. You shall not die, but you shall live. I don't care if the doctor says you got 3 minutes to live. You're gonna live.
That's right.
The medical, the professional in the room says he has 3 more minutes to live. And I'm in the room. Are you kidding me? I'm gonna say in my spirit, I rebuke that doctor. And I continue to speak what? Life. You understand me? Life. You got that? In whose name?
Jesus.
So, this is the way it works. When you pray for someone, don't you be sitting there like a preacher once told me. A little boy was unconscious in the parking lot at a subdivision. The neighbor came and knocked on the preacher's door because knew that the girl was an evangelist and said, come out and pray. She wouldn't pray. That's why she told me. She was scared that if I pray for him and he died, the whole neighborhood gonna know. Who cares?
That's right.
Are you kidding me? I'm like this preacher. Preacher said, if I lay hands on 1,000 people and not one of them get healed, I'm going to say, next. Next. You understand me, preachers?
Yes.
Understand me, people?
Yes.
Don't you be in there concerned if they die and I pray for them. I'm glad you prayed for them. And guess what? The next one, you're going to do the same thing. And the next one, and the next one, and the next one. Until you see Jesus.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
Now, say it.
Because he came out of the coma.
See, they were happy because he came out of the coma.
Right. So then that's when he called me the next day.
The next day.
He was dead.
Got
it, but I didn't know how they would get it because first it was a high price.
Yeah. Remember I said.
I had to choose my words, you know.
You had to choose your words carefully.
Right. For when I told them again because I didn't want them to. to be mad at God and say, how did you do this? So that's why, that's when I called
you. People get mad at God all the time, though. You can't be concerned with that. They get, look, I'm going to say it because I believe it. I believe Michael Jordan, the great Michael Jordan, is still mad at God. I think he's mad at God. He changed after his daddy was murdered. Do you understand me? I think Michael Jordan got mad at God after the death of his daddy. And his mama is saved. But I believe he got mad at God. I bet a guy ran the corner and told me he was mad at God because his daddy beat his mama. And his mama had an early death. But he was mad at God. He told me he was mad at God. I made a house call and he was mad at God. You understand me? Brother Tyrone, Sister Sheila, God bless y'all and the kids.
Amen.
Now get this now. So the little boy died. He came out of the coma and died the next day, didn't he? The next day he was dead. So we pray for that family. Yeah. Oh, you spoke to the sister?
I got to speak to her because that's who Miracle's friend is. So she was like, I'm glad I'm at peace with her. So
oh, she was at peace with her.
Yeah, she was at peace.
How old is his sister?
She has to be around Miracle's age because they go to school together.
So around what?
18.
18? Mm-hmm. And this 14-year-old little boy is now dead. Mm-hmm. I'll give him some air for me, please. Holly here. So now, Bridget, how you doing? So we're going to walk. Now get this, you ready? Now, I gave them Psalm 107:20. I gave them Matthew 10:1. Now, get this. Same day, I get in my car and I come over here and I'm parked right there where that Taco Bell is. It's raining yesterday, am I right? When I get out the car, I see a car behind me with 666 on its license plate. 666 on his license plate. And it was raining. I didn't have no umbrella. I didn't care. I'm a soldier. So guess what I did? I stepped out, I saw the 666, but I saw the car running. I looked. I saw that someone was sitting in there with the mark of the beast. I went back to my truck. I took out a flyer. And I walked over to the window. I knocked on his window. I did like this. You know what that means, don't you?
Turn your window down.
I did that. But he had good sense. He put it down halfway. He put it like this, you know what I'm saying? So to let him know that I wasn't begging or coming to rob him, I said, I'm Pastor Angelo O. Jones, and I got to tell you something. I want to tell you that you got the mark of the beast, 666, on your license tag. And I said, listen to me, sir. Let me explain something to you. The mark of the beast is real. The Bible says in Revelation 14:11, whosoever receiving this mark, get no rest day nor night. And the smoke of their torment extended up forever and ever and ever. So I looked at him, let him roll a joint. The girl was sitting on the passenger side. She's looking, and he's like, you know, he's rolling. I care. He can roll all the joints he wants. I'm going to do my job. So he's rolling. He said, look, man, he ain't going with it. He said, look, man, thank you, but I'm in a hurry right now. I said, well, listen, before you go, let me tell you this. Not only, I said, some people just think it's the mark. No, sir. The Bible says it's Satan's name in numbers. God. I said, sir, you got Satan's name on your tag, on your car, on your life. I said, let me tell you what's going on with you. unclean spirits, negative spirits, are going to be drawn to you automatically. Because they're drawn to the name. They're drawn to that number. So I say, all hell break out in your life. All negativity come in. You don't know where it's coming from. You got the curse of the mark of the beast on you, man. He said, yeah. I said, now, so I said, listen, here's what you do. I said, man, I've been doing this forever. Take my flyer and go on YouTube, see how I operate. Go on Periscope, whatever you got to see. Because I know what I'm talking about. So I said, now, here's what you do. I said, you go to the NBA and tell them you want a new tag. NBA going to tell you, we're not going to give you a new tag. We're not giving you a new tag number. I said, all you got to say then is this. Because of religious reasons, I want a new tag. By law, they can't tear you down. They got to give you a new tag. You got a social security number with 666 in your social security number, you in big trouble. You got to go there in person and say, because of religious reasons, you got to give me another social security number. You got a bank card. Your son's bank account was jacked up. Something always happened with it?
Always.
What did he have on the account?
666 inside of the account number.
Inside the account number. So I told him, you got me? So hold up. Now, after I pulled off from him of giving him that information, I pulled on Branch Avenue. Here come a car on the side of me, lose control and start doing all kinds of stuff. Hit the side, hit the railing. Boom. Bounced off doing a 360. And I'm thinking they're going to hit me. Satan wanted me. But guess what? They were a little behind me. I'm like this. I'm watching them spin. I'm watching Charlie around. But they didn't die. The car turned around, going the opposite direction. And cars were able to stop in time. So I kept on going. I got to my destination. What do? I drive up on the curb. After I leave there, I make a turn out there. Guess what? I fishtail. I come back to another place. I'm in the store. When I come, the rug did something funny. And I almost fell flat on my face. Liar. See, when you have the full arm of God upon you, when you got the whole armor of God from head to toe, he might strike, he might attack, he might fire some of the fiery darts, but guess what? They will not be able to destroy you, will not be able to harm you or hurt you. All hell can make a home. 1,000 can fall by the wayside, 10,000 can fall by the wayside, but it won't come down my will. You can live in the biggest crime neighborhood in America and nothing will touch your house. Holy Ghost power is real. You understand me? It's real. That's what's wrong with the church today. Ignoring the spirituality of it all. And what's wrong with the church today? We become so intellectual. We become so worldly. We become so ritualistic. We become so programmed that we don't have any power left. And Satan wants the church like that. No power, no deliverance. No power, no miracles. No power, no healings. You understand me? Say it, Maxine. Now say it loud. Hold on for a second. Come up here and ask me. Because I can't hear you at all. Anaya, it's your daughter. Which one of them is Anaya? Okay. Now, which one of them had that problem?
Anaya.
Anaya, come here, please. Come and be with your mama. Watch this. Set it down that way or step over. There's a healer in the house. And his name is?
Jesus.
It's real. Something you just told me about one of your daughters too. Was it Anaya? No, not that. Something physical. Something with some sickness. Something you told me recently and they weren't here.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, I have two questions. The first one.
Okay, what's the question you want to ask?
I want to stay on that. Her dad has his own business, so she was doing invoice for him. And okay. It was like, I think it's probably like, I don't know how many numbers is it. I don't know. It's probably like 10. It's 9. Okay, it's 9. But the last 6 of it was like 666, and then it was like 321. So she brought it to me. She asked me what to do because she had to put it in the system. So that it can go through and get paid. So I said, well, let's pray about it, let's rebuke it. But I wanted to ask you, what should have we, did we do the right thing by praying and rebuking it?
Good question. Excellent question. And they need the answer to this. Here's the deal. There are going to be times when you're going to come across the mark of the beast and you can't do anything about it. Physically. You won't be able to do anything about it. Because it's out of your hand to physically get it changed. So you did right. You have to come against it. Just don't look at it and go on as usual. You got to rebuke it. You got to bind it up. And you got to speak to that thing and curse it with a curse from God and kill it. You got to kill that mark. Hear me? Now, that invoice. All of them don't come like that with that same 66, do they?
No.
There's nothing you can do with it, but you got to do what your mama told you to do. You have to fight it. You hear me? When that mark of the beast come into your business, come into your house, you got to fight it. Amen. Didn't I tell you that Prince George's County just hand out trash cans all over my neighborhood and all trash cans got 666 on them? You think that's by coincidence? Free trash cans from Prince George's County government and all of them got 666 on them. Do you know what it's going to do to those families, the houses that's using it for trash? I'm getting ready to take an axe to it. I don't use it no more. I'm getting ready to destroy it, but I'm going to help my neighbors out. They can cuss me out if they want to. I don't care. But I'm going to let them know that their trash can got the mark of the beast on it. You hear me? So you did right. What's the other thing?
Where her hormones, like she'd come on her cycle and she'd
bleed
for like 34 to 36 days.
That's a torment from hell.
It'd be so bad till she had to stay home. She
used
to have to stay home for like 2 weeks out of
the Oh my God, you're getting healed today.
So
hold on. All right then, women. All right then, let's get this straight. How old are you?
17.
Okay. How long has this been happening since she was what age?
Since she was like 11.
Oh my God. Hold on, stop right there. Women. She has a period. Her menstrual cycle. And her menstrual cycle sometimes is 30 to 34 days straight.
Straight. And then she'll stop bleeding, but it'd be so heavy. She can stand up and come down like water. It'll go away, then she'll come back 4 months. And then so they put her on this medication that she has to take for 10 days. And it stopped it. It slowed it down. But she kept... She and I understand her. She's healed. She said, "You said, and she's healed by God." But she didn't take it like she's supposed to. In February, so now she's been on her cycle since March 21st.
Hold on. What's today's date?
March 23rd.
That's a month from a couple of days.
So she has to go back into the doctor on Tuesday because her iron is so low. Does they have to inject her?
Well, that's why the iron is low.
Right, and her vitamin D
is
supposed to be a 32 and it's a 7.
Hold on. It's supposed to be a 32 and it's a 7. And it's vitamin D deficiency. Oh, God bless y'all here today. Okay. And Ms. Lauren. As soon as you get Ms. Lauren, I want to ask him something. Good gracious. Mr. Lawrence, come here, I need you. Ms. Lauren? Ms. Lauren? Tell them about the woman who had been bleeding, the last one came here. How long was she bleeding? And she wasn't bleeding for 30 days. She was bleeding every day for how many years, Ms. Lauren?
3 years.
How long?
3.
3 years and she was bleeding.
Nonstop.
Women, y'all hear me, women? Women, do y'all hear me? This woman was bleeding for 3 years from her womanhood. Women, y'all don't want to be on a period for a week.
Not 3 days.
That's right. From day one, you, oh no, it's that time of month, get out of here. Am I right? This young girl bleeding for a month. But this woman bleeding for 3 years, right? And she came in here. Uh-oh. Are we going to get it? We going to get it. So, Ms. Long, what do we do for her? What do we do for her? 3 years of bleeding.
Yeah, 3 years. And after the service, she came up here.
Oh, that's right. She didn't want to.
Yeah, she didn't want to.
She didn't want to do it in the open.
Publicly.
Y'all, this ain't that kind of gentler church where you hide an issue. Psst, Pastor, there's a deep message. There's a deep message. What did you say? And then I got to do this. Heaven's back. In heaven's back, there is no what?
Judging.
There is no what?
Judging.
Okay, then. And then they'll tell her. But she came to me after the service. What happened?
Yeah, and she came right here, stood right here. And, you know, we were dismissing. And I, Pastor said, Pastor, just lay a hand on her. Mm. And after he did that night, he used Mark chapter 5.
Sure did, chapter 5.
Verse 25.
Through
34.
That's right.
After I saw what happened that night, I said, Pastor, I didn't tell him. I said, I'm going to memorize verse 25 through 34.
Because I had already memorized it.
Yeah. And
not he used it
spoke
on.
That. And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years.
12 years.
And I suffered many things of
many doctors.
And I spent all that she had.
Hey.
All that she had.
But what happened this long?
And was nothing better.
But what?
But rather grew worse. Amen. Yeah. And amen. She came to Jesus.
She heard about that. Yeah, but when she heard of Jesus,
she said, if I may touch.
But his what? Straight away.
After I saw that night, amen. The woman came back the next day. Mm. Said it stopped immediately.
After 3 years.
So there is
a woman in the house.
There's power in that word. Amen.
Because the Bible says she felt within herself
that she was healed.
It says straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up. We want this fountain dried up. Because of the body that she was healed of her plague. Jesus called it a plague. She was a plague. She dealing with the same plague. I want her healed.
Amen.
And Ms. Long, we've had others too that was bleeding and stopped.
We've had people come by here.
Bleeding for no reason.
We had a young lady from Germantown, Pastor.
Yeah.
Years ago, she had the same problem. She was bleeding like for a year.
Oh, God. Yeah,
wouldn't stop.
And what we do for her?
Well, you laid hands on her. But Sister Agnes, she had that same problem too.
Bleeding.
Yeah, the bleeding. The woman with the issue of blood. And non-stop periods.
Non-stop periods. That's a torment from the pit of hell, y'all.
Yes.
No woman should be bleeding like that. That woman with issue of blood. She wanted God so bad, she spent all her money on doctors.
That's right.
And doctors couldn't heal her.
Nothing better. Yeah. Spiritualism.
Yeah. Doctors couldn't stop her bleeding. They took her money, though. Jesus healed her for free. I said for free. Do you hear me?
No, that's what we're talking about.
Well, thank you, Mrs. Lauren.
Amen.
It's time for her. So look, Lil, why don't you stand right here?
Oh, Pastor.
Say it.
Saying that you're mentioning that pain.
Yeah.
You don't have to pay for your healing.
Come on here.
Amen.
Amen. And we always tell people, I just was speaking with a young lady in here right now who was just telling me, I'm not going to call her name.
Uh-huh.
But somebody was charging her $2,500 to come and get delivered.
Hold on, Ms. Law.
$2,500. But
hold on.
Huh?
Hold on. 2,500.
Smackaroos.
Okay, go ahead.
But the word of God is real clear. He said in Matthew chapter 10, as ye go, preach saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Heal the sick.
Cleanse the lepers.
Come on. Raise the dead.
Cast out devils.
Ah! I love this.
Freely.
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 Freely. Freely you have what?
Receive.
So freely do what else?
Freely give. Amen. So if they're charging you money, run for your life.
Hold on, Ms. Lauren. A hater on Periscope last Sunday, a hater. Uh-huh. When we was cast those demons off of someone from Oklahoma who flew in here. The other night. No, not Sunday, but that night that either used Warren or used Warren for. You know what he said? He said, he put on Periscope. He said, another money hungry pastor. How much does this cost? See, I don't block hazels. God told me, don't even, I don't care if they cuss me, I don't care if they call me, I don't block them. I got a pastor friend, you say anything, he don't like it. He'll block 20 people in an hour. I seen him do it. He's blocking his preacher. Now you don't like what he's saying, and I'm talking about your boy, Evangelist D. I'm talking about your boy.
He was all over
the Periscope. He was. So look, but I saw what he said. So guess what I did? While she down there shaking and spitting up and growling and stuff, I saw what he said. I said, I pointed to her. I said, and this is free. And this is free. Don't cost you nothing. I ain't seen my brother no more that night. This is free. Don't cost nothing.
There should be no charge for the gospel. Amen. So, well, we have had a lot of people come in here. We even had our friend, Brother Willie, from Mississippi. He went to a lot of people to try to get spirits off of him. And they were charging large
big money. Oh, he paid a lot of money.
Paid a lot of money.
He paid a lot.
Yeah.
He paid thousands. I know a lady who mailed 1,500 over to the West End. The West Indies.
Yeah, to Trinidad.
Trinidad. She mailed 1,500, uh-huh. And then she flew over there and gave them the other 1,500.
Uh-huh.
And she's a Christian.
Not
why did she do it? I figured it out. If you are in a nice church and you haven't seen the power and you need help, you can't even take it to your pastor because he's not dealing with the spiritual thing. You can't tell nobody in the church because they'll think you're crazy, think you're a nut. You go tell one of them what she told us here the other day. You go tell one of those pastors. You go tell one of those kind of gender churches that a demon is raping me in my bed at night. Front and back with her. You go tell that to them and see what they do. They'll kick you out of that church. I knew she was being raped. She said she was. I know she was. She was. She ain't the only woman been in here with that. We've had hundreds of them, all ages for years, and we deal with it. We shut that strong man down. Had him from all ages, from childhood to 90. You better know where you're sitting today. You better know where you are. So it's real. Everything you're hearing is real. Now, she's going to Dr. Nguyen. Say it better than that. Hold on. Stop right there. You got a sister that stayed on her cycle for 3 months. Yes. I'll bring that cycle up in here.
It's been so that she can't even work.
Oh, guess what? She can't work.
She has no energy.
And no energy. I love your family. You tell her, give her a personal message for me. Tell her I said it. She bring that thing up into this supernatural medical center. Jesus is going to stop the fountain of her blood. They're going to shut that fountain of blood up. You're going to dry it up. You hear me? Tell exactly what I said. Did I say I hope so?
No.
Sister, did you hear me say maybe? Thank you, Evangelist. Say it, Pastor.
Well, Pastor, I want to be truthful with you. I ask God to help me keep my mouth closed today. Because
you know you can't keep your mouth closed in heaven's best.
I could not.
We know you're busy today, Pastor, but you know what kind of church this is. Hey, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is what?
Liberty.
And I realize it, and this is my home, but I still want it to be quiet, but I can't.
No, go ahead.
I have to say this. You remember the diagnosis that was on me.
Come on up here. Come on. Pastor, come on. That's right. Pastor, come on. A living testimony. Pastor, come on. Come on, Pastor.
And I'm dealing with tendonitis.
Come on, Pastor.
Thank you.
Pastor, you come up in here.
Thank you.
She passes in Washington, D.C., y'all. You standing right there, Pastor. Talk to me.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
I felt this was important. I had ovarian cancer. But the ovarian cancer came as a result of the treatment that was given for the irregular bleeding.
Stop right there. Don't stop right there. I'm going to soak that in. Hold up. You dealing with ovarian cancer and the medical treatment for the bleeding was first.
That's right.
How much were you bleeding at the time?
It was just prolonged. It was monthly, but prolonged.
But prolonged.
It was past menopause.
And the medical treatment caused the problem.
It was hormone treatment. And when you take the hormone treatment, then it resulted in the cancer.
Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Thank you for this information. No, you couldn't keep your mouth shut. See, listen to me. You couldn't keep your mouth shut. You know why? Because God wants us to know every way the unclean spirit is working against humanity.
Yes.
We need to uncover different things so we know how to war. And so sometime in here, we've heard a lot, but we're never going to hear it all. How about this? Some churches don't hear anything. You don't get the mic in their church. You don't get to say nothing in their church. You shut your mouth up in there. If you're not a deacon, you ain't touching that microphone.
Amen.
You hear me?
They don't get to touch it. But doesn't the word say that when the house is clean, the demon says, I will return to my home.
That's right.
And it will bring seven with it. And the state of that person is worse than it was in the beginning. Amen?
Swept and garnished.
Swept and garnished.
He'll come back to his house.
So you bind and you loose so that it's full. It's not empty. But I was sitting when the mother came up with this child and said, they're going to prescribe medication or some course of helping her. And I'm like, that course could be the same as my course.
And we don't want that.
No.
You're not here by no accident or coincidence. Come in, Mama. Call, because we're going to take care of your daughter up in here today.
But Pastor, you know that there are no coincidences.
No, it's not. Remember? And we don't use the word accident.
Would you
no such thing.
That I was out of town relocating my brother. And somebody gave misinformation that my church was closed today. And so I said to the people when I spoke with them, be at peace, go along your way, because there's somewhere I want to go. Then the place I want to be, but you know what? We are not our own. The steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord. And we overcome by what? The blood of the Lamb and the testimony and the word of our testimony. So my testimony was supposed to be here so that I can back up what you're going to do. And God would not allow me to sit down. My mouth works for him. It's surrendered to him. And I need to learn how to close it when he's not telling me to open it. But when he does tell me to open it, I have to speak. Amen.
Now, what's going on with you now? Your tendonitis.
In my foot.
Oh, we're going to deal with that today. Now, remember, hold on. See this pastor? She's also from my university. She's a Howard University alum.
Bison
in the house. She's a Howard graduate. But hold on. Guess what, y'all? When she was in high school, she had a project to do. What was the project?
Witchcraft.
What did you do for your project?
I brought all these books into my room, and then a strong man started showing up.
And messing with you?
Definitely. No sleep.
No, he didn't open the books.
Right. You never did the project, but you brought them in your room.
In my room. Brought the books in from the library.
That's right.
And from that moment on, hell broke out.
It materialized
in your room.
That's right.
For years.
Yes. All through college.
All through college.
34 years.
Yeah, it was.
Until you got here.
Right.
Well, yes. Wait. I mean, this was. It stopped tormenting me when I got married. However, other things happened after I got here.
For instance, there was something blowing on her vagina. Remember that?
Cold air.
There was cold air blowing on her female organ. You better hear me, church. Blowing cold air every now and then.
That's right. But it would wait until I was sitting where my husband was, and it would run up on me. You know, I could see it just run up on me and start blowing cold air. Because he didn't want me, like you said, he thought I was losing my mind. So I couldn't say anything.
Had to keep it to yourself because they didn't understand. See, the devil wants you to be like a man. I told you, a man on an island. If they can get you to keep it to yourself, isolate you.
That's right.
Then you are in trouble. If you got no one who you can talk to who will understand that, hold on. Look, a lot of times you run to the doctor. And the doctor said, I don't see anything. There's nothing there. Blah, 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 blah. Can't help you. But you know there's something there. You know your own body.
That's right.
But yet no one can help you. Guess what? And when you try to tell someone, they don't understand. So here you are. Wide open to the enemy now. That's why we tell people, bring that thing to us. I'm never going to tell you, no, that's not true. I don't believe that. Something wrong. Go do this. When you tell me, I'm going to say, I know you're right.
Amen.
And we're going to get them off of you. You hear me, people?
Amen.
Now, stop right there because I just remember something. Same spot you're standing in now. Stand here for a second. Same spot you're standing in now. Oh, by the way, I don't snort cocaine anymore. So I'm not high. I'm not at the club getting drunk, so I'm not high. So what I'm about to tell you is real. That thing that was blowing on her. Same spot. She's standing in now years ago. I saw him in the spirit. I saw him. I saw him. He was hanging on to her. This whole side. He was hanging on like a pet monkey. But he was holding on to her. But guess what he was? I saw him. He looked like a... what's that little small crazy dinosaur?
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Yeah, that one. Tyrannosaurus Rex. He was hanging on to her. And that's what he looked like. I saw him. I asked the Lord, hold on. Hold on, stop right there. Hold on, stop right there. Right. I wasn't smoking reefer that day. Because I hadn't done it in 20-some years. Open your Bible right now. I want you to understand what I'm about to tell you about this pastor right here. I want you to go to Jeremiah. Raise your hand if you have a Bible, because you're going to use this for the rest of your life. Do you understand me? Amen. Hold your hand if you don't have a Bible, because you need this. Satan wants you to be spiritually ignorant, but you're not going to be spiritually ignorant hanging around this place. Amen. Periscope, you're not going to be spiritually ignorant. Facebook Live, you're not going to be spiritually ignorant. Go tell your cousin I said it. That's right. Hand that Bible. I want you to go to Jeremiah 50. Miss Norma, see my Bible? Turn to Jeremiah 50:25 for me, Miss Norma. I'm going to tell you what happened. She's standing in the exact same spot. When people talk about you for being spiritual, but one day they're going to need you. One day they're going to need you to be spiritual. Believe me, that's right. Sooner than later. You being spiritual can save their life. Some people about to lose their mind, have a nervous breakdown, will need you to get spiritual and get that demon out. Let me ask Miss Lauren. Now that I got my hands free. Now, go to Jeremiah 50 and go to verse 25. Are y'all there?
Yes.
Father, in the name of Jesus, teach, Holy Ghost. Teach. It says here, the Lord had opened. That's the ED?
Yes.
Was the ED on? What does that mean? Already what? Already done. The Lord had opened his armory. Do you see armory?
Yes.
You do see armory. You do know what an armory is, don't you?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
An armory is a place that contains weapons. Uh-oh. An armory has weapons of mass destruction. All of it. Do you understand me? When they go to the armory, now you gotta hear me. Can they go into the armory and take a weapon out and keep it?
No.
Once they use it, what do they have to do with it?
Return it.
Uh-oh, boy, you teaching, boy. Come on up in here. They have to return that weapon, don't they? Give them a Bible for me. Give them a brother Reggie a Bible. I tell them where to turn. Karen, tell your brother where to turn. Now, they have to return it, don't they? They just can't take it and keep it at home locked up in the closet again. No, they got to get that thing back, am I right?
Amen.
Hold up now. Some of y'all didn't even know that God had an armory.
Teach.
And he has it.
That's right.
And I know what that means. He said he's the Lord had opened E.D. up his armory. What? So there's some stuff in there. Hold up. Miss Lauren, grab the Bible And turn to Ephesians 6 for me. And get on that side over there.
13.
Mm-hmm. Hey, come on over here. Now, it said the Lord have opened his army and have brought forth the weapons. He brought forth what?
Weapons.
God is a man of war. The Lord is his name. So what am I doing in a church that don't know about weapons? What am I doing sitting up in a church and I got an issue and they don't know how to go to the armory and get a weapon? Are you kidding me? Premature deaths all over the place and they don't know how to go to the weaponry. So it says here, brought forth the weapons of his indignation. Now what does indignation mean? He don't like it.
He's angry.
You hear me? He is angry. And when God is angry, he got a weapon for you. Do you understand me? Come on, stand up in here. Come on, stand up in here. Oh, I got you. I told you it's for Holy Ghost power today, didn't it? So hold up. It says here, the Lord have opened his arm and have brought forth the weapons of his indignation. For this is the work of who?
The Lord.
And Miss Lauren, what does Ephesians 6:10 say?
Finally.
No, get that mic.
Ephesians 6:10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And in the power of his might.
Hold on. Be strong in who?
In the Lord.
And in the power of what?
Of his might.
Keep going.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Uh-huh.
That's ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Uh-huh.
For we wrestle not against flesh.
Hold on. What?
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
But what?
Against principalities.
Hold on. Stop it there. Guess what?
Principality.
You know what a principality is? Mm-hmm. It's a prince demon.
Mm-hmm.
A demon with some authority. A demon, a prince demon, only answers to Satan himself. A prince demon has an army under him. And he tells them what to do according to what Satan told him to tell them what to do. There are principalities all over this country. Do you understand me? When you finish, we're going to take your spot, praise. When you're ready, Trinity's taking her spot. Now, a principality, you better hear me. Do you show you how spiritual this is? You seen different neighborhoods? Okay. Some neighborhoods have more murder crimes in it than other neighborhoods. Am I right? There are certain neighborhoods, man, that their murder rate can triple everybody else put together. Guess why? They don't know that there's a prince of power, there's a prince demon over that neighborhood. See, how can you tell what kind of principality is involved by what's vicious and what is the majority of the negativity in that area? That prince demon of murders in some neighborhoods. If you got another neighborhood where there's prostitutes all on the corner, do you know what kind of principality that is? Suppose you got another neighborhood and everybody in the neighborhood is poor, poverty stricken. You got a principality to deal with. He's a prince demon of poverty. He want everybody broke, so what they'll do? Oh, you know what they'll do.
Daniel, Prince of Persia.
Prince of Persia, fighting. Now, you're not fighting flesh and blood. Get off of that. You're going to need his armory. You're going to need the weapons of an open armory. Keep going, Mrs. Lauren. Principality, then what?
Against powers.
Hold on, powers.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. What kind of powers? Economic powers?
No.
Education power?
No.
Oh, must be black power. Social power, medical power, scientific power, white power, brown power, red power. No! is spiritual power, is unclean transgressors, unclean trespassers, coming against humanity, powers of darkness, powers of curses, powers of demons, powers of witches and warlocks, powers of generational curses, powers from hell, and you sitting around playing church. Oh God, somebody, oh God, just hear my, I just heard this one. Those same powers of alcoholism, power of drug addiction. You got more heroin overdose now than you ever had in the history of this country. Opiates is claiming lives like it. Oh, they just celebrated Prince yesterday. It was Prince Day. Why? Because 1 year to the day, power killed him. Go ahead, Ms. Long. Powers of what else? Rulers?
Against the rulers of darkness of this world.
Stop right there. Darkness. Rulers of darkness. Everything that you're dealing with comes from rulers of darkness. There's negativity in the dark. The Bible says that a man will do evil in the dark because he don't want to come to the light. Because you'll uncover his dastardly deeds. So rulers, how many rules of darkness are already messing with your family? Are you kidding me? How many rules of darkness been ruling over your finances all your life? How many rules of darkness keeping your relatives from getting saved? Oh, how many rules of darkness keeping children from even speaking to their mom and dad anymore? Oh boy, again, I'm going back to Summer again. She got raped at the age of 2. She got raped at the age of 2. 1 of 3 persons did. By the way, y'all, I'm going to tell y'all this. She don't know which one of the 3, but she named the 3. They were all kin to her. Now get this. When she looked at herself on Periscope with us Warren, she said, it's real in there. She said, they are some awesome people. And know what else she said? She said, Lord, help me to remember who did it so I can forgive them. Amen. I know you're looking at something. Guess what else she did? Before she flew from Oklahoma to get here last week, she was shacking. How many of y'all here shacking? She was shackled. Miss Long told me what she did. Guess what she did? Boy, she hung right here for a week and started getting her life together. She hung right here for a week. She went back to Oklahoma and know what she did? Moved into a shelter. She said, I ain't shacking no more. Y'all hear me? The power of God hit that girl in here, changed her life. She didn't even look the same as she left here. Then God prayed for her. She went back and went for a shelter. Tell them to go back to a shack in her sister. Thank God they will give her own place. Thank God they will bless her with her own place. That's what Summer did, y'all. She got back. What's the last one there? Then that was finished.
Against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Spiritual wickedness in high places. Pharmaceutical company is a spiritual wickedness in high places. Give you some medicine that can do the same thing to you. But God had her here to help y'all. had to stop here to tell you something. There are too many children. Spiritual wickedness in high places is why we are drugging elementary school students in school. They're fidgety. Drug them. Liar. Spiritual wickedness in high places is why a man can marry a man. And a woman can marry a what? Woman. Spiritual wickedness in high places is why I can go out there on the corner and smoke a joint and a cop can pass by and I wave at it while smoking it. It's legal. Y'all hear me? Say it. Come in. Come in. Hear her. She said that she was 32 years been a lesbian. Come here. Boy, it's good up in here today. Come on up in here, sister. So come on up here and talk to me. Come on up here and talk to me today. Come on, take this microphone. Come on up in here. Hold on. How many years?
32 years. It was on me since age 10, so it's actually more than 30.
Hold on. Age 10.
It was on me at age 10.
You had attraction for other women at age of 10. Had you ever been molested as a child?
At 5 years old, somebody touched me.
Was it another woman?
No, it wasn't.
A man did. At age of 5. Okay, go ahead, talk to me.
And 32 years ago, when God talked to me, he said it was a sin, but I let iniquity take over.
That's right.
And let it wrap up in me, and I pushed God away. And August 2016, the third is when God pulled me up.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Stop it there. Y'all better shout.
Your
mouth, but you've been speaking with your heart. What's your name?
Tanya.
Stay first name for me.
T-A-N-Y-A.
Sister Tanya. For 32 years, a sodomite. 32 years, a sodomite woman. She didn't want it, she said. But she was speaking it here, but not here. Tell me something. How did you get delivered from 32 years of being attracted to women and not men? How did you get delivered? Come on, tell me what happened.
Power of God. I asked God to come in and deliver me. And
you did.
He set me free.
He took away from me.
He delivered me, and he said there will be no refugees.
And I believe that. No residue. And guess what? Guess what? I'm serious. The spirit on you, I see all woman on you. Now, how did you find us?
Actually, my spiritual godmother, Pastor Renee, she told us about you.
What city?
She lives in this city.
Okay.
She went to Atlanta to do some work, and God is bringing her back this way.
And she told you about us?
Yep.
What city do you live in now? Oh man, you're right next door. It is your season. And God is getting ready to do something with you. You understand me? For instance, Leo. When we was on the radio, I made an announcement on the radio. I said, if anybody want to be delivered from being a lesbian or a homosexual, I did it before I started using sodomite like God told me. I said, anyone want to be delivered from being a lesbian or a homosexual, meet me at heaven's best, and I'm going to war for you, and it's going to happen. Sure enough, a girl showed up, and she sat in the back, and she looked like a man, but she was a woman. She sat in the back, didn't open her mouth, didn't say anything, and didn't come up for prayer. You got me? Well, we were opening like every day then. She showed up again, and again, and again. Same thing, she sat back there and didn't say a word. She looked like a man. She was a lesbian. But that next Sunday, I made the call. No, that Friday night, I made the call. She got up and she came up. So I prayed for a war for her. She fell out of the spirit. When she got up, she ran out in the parking lot. She started dancing in the parking lot. She got in the car and started driving around to 2 or 3 in the morning, knocking on friends' doors, telling them that she was a woman and she wanted a man, and she was no longer a lesbian, that she had got delivered and set free. She came back in here that Sunday. Came back in here with makeup on, with a dress on. You better hear me. The same one. She didn't look like a man no more. And guess what? She's still a woman. She moved back to her hometown in Pittsburgh, and she is a preacher. Preaching to all the women. Going to the streets, she says. Preaching to them. Give her testimony. I'm telling you that because God got something for you to do. Okay? So get ready, okay? But I'm going to give you this right now. I'm going to give you an anointing to take with you, okay? Anything else you want to say, bro? And God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul, so that from his body was brought unto the sick, handkerchiefs of aprons, the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits went out of them. Acts 19, chapter verse 11 and 12. Don't ever wash it. Keep it until Jesus Christ release you from it. And you carry it any kind of way you want to. You can sleep on it, carry it with you, whatever. Anything else you want to say? So now, I mean, you got delivered last August. God, I love it. And God took me to tell you, you will stay delivered. No more sodomite delivered to you. Over. And I'm going to do it. Now, who's you bring with you?
Brother and Sister Francis.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to get to them in a second. As soon as I finish this, I'm going to get to both of them in a second, okay? But I'm glad you're here, Sister Tan. Sister Tan, do me a favor. Don't be a stranger, okay? Hallelujah now. Thank you. Come on, give God praise for this woman. For this woman of God. For this woman of God. Now. Okay, now you see the armory, right? Uh-oh. Come on, stand in this spot. Right there. Now. See the armory? He said the weapons, right?
Yep.
Huh? Now. Ooh. It's 50 to 25. You saw it, right? Now. So. I reached up to the armory. Let me hear you say supernatural.
Supernatural.
The armory is supernatural. The armory is spiritual. You can't go and fill out a card and leave your ID and borrow a weapon from the armory. Okay? So, I reached up here. Now, here's the thing now. God will give you a weapon if you believe. You will see the weapon with your supernatural vision, your spiritual vision, if you believe and trust God to give you a weapon. Some of y'all need some weapons at your home. And I ain't talking about 38 and 45 either. And a knife and a switchblade. Some of y'all already got those in the house, ain't heavy yet. Still got hell in your house. But the spiritual weapon, God Almighty, I reached up. And he'll give me a weapon to use many times. Hold on now. Guess what? After you use it, you just can't just. After you use it, you got to do what?
Give it back.
Got to give it back. He may give you another one right then and there. Or he may give you the same weapon, a fresh one. Now, this pastor standing here. Now, this thing been blowing on her private part for years. She's seen him. She can tell nobody.
Do you remember, for some reason, you may have been out of town, but I came on a day in the week, and the other ministers were here.
Uh-huh.
And my dress was blowing. And it knocked Evangelist Rachel down. And they were all, they were all fighting for me, but nobody could get it off with me.
Good God Almighty. Evangelist Rachel lives in, is it North Dakota?
Yeah, North Dakota.
And guess what? She saw us on Periscope Warren for summer. She saw us on Facebook. I'm sorry, Facebook Live. And know she said, I really miss Warren with y'all guys. She said, I miss Warren with you guys. She married and got a baby living in North Dakota now. And by the way, she's Caucasian too. And she was licensed in this church.
Yes, she did.
And you knocked Rachel out the way.
It knocked Rachel out the way. Pastor, I always call him Rabbi. Minister over here, and I had not been ordained yet or licensed. So you were out of town and it knocked her down, and some of your others were, your other ministers were fighting, but they couldn't get it off.
It was blowing up the dress.
My dress was just going like this. Everybody who came around me was cold. I'm talking about frigid. You could see the cold air.
Excuse me for a minute. That's a demon. Who could she go tell that? I just say you go tell them that to First Church of the Nazarene. excuse me, but there was no. She can go tell 13th Baptist Church.
Nope.
No. How about 15th Presbyterian? No.
No.
Now.
But when you came back.
Now, this one, I saw it when God revealed to me. Better look at me now. I said, God, I saw that thing. He was ferocious. He was ugly. Hold on to the side of him. I said, Lord, I need a weapon. And he gave me one. He gave me this big chains. You hear me? You better hear me. He gave me a weapon. It was like a net. You know, like a net you cast for fish? And it's made out of what?
Metal.
Cord, right? Cord for fish. But this was metal. And I came over here like this. I had it in my hand. You better hear me. From his armory. No one gave me a net made out of iron and metal and steel, whatever it was made out of. No one gave it. He gave it to me. And I could see it. And I could hold it in my hand. And I told you what I had. And I stood right here. And I took that net, didn't I? And I threw it. Oh yeah. I threw it on. And the whole net covered him. And when the net got him, I pulled him off her body. Didn't I? Pulled him out of the body. And I pulled him all the way out the door. He was struggling when he couldn't get out. And when I took him out the door, two angels. Two big strong angels, Warren angels, dropped down on the side of him. One had this on, one had this on. Didn't look at me, didn't say a word to me. Boom, it was gone with him. Have you seen him since?
No.
Have you blown on him since? And I'm going to call my ass.
If I feel anything that's not coming off me and I rebuke it and tell it in Jesus' name what will happen to it if it doesn't get out of my face.
Amen.
It's the methods from the army that we use. So what you told her, we got to shut that up now so she won't take. We got to
and I took no chemo. It's the fire of God that burned in me and burned every cancerous cell out. And 5 years later, when they keep checking me, my numbers are below what they're supposed to be.
A new man's favor. She's a pastor. But a new man's favor. For you being here today, and this is Holy Ghost power, and everybody's getting ready to heal and set free. Weapons are coming. Hand you free. She's going to stop bleeding. I'm going to get an arthritis out of your hip. Do me a favor. Give a harmony out. Do me a favor. What are you feeling in your spirit? There's something melodic in the atmosphere. Don't do it.
Oh, how I love Jesus. And oh, how I love, I really do, Jesus. And oh, because you first love me. Oh, how I love to hear your name and claim your name. And oh, how I love to speak your name, yes, and use your name. And oh, how I love you, Jesus.
I knew this was going to have a good time
today. Because you
I love her.
Hallelujah.
Love her whole family. She know it. Miss Lawn and I, she love us, we love them. Now, Taraji, give me the microphone for Taraji. I need a woman. Hold on. Here's what I need. I need a female preacher who don't have any problems with her period. I want you. Huh? Come on in. Oh, here come one right here.
I'll tell you, it's free in here.
She said, it's free in here. Hey, y'all, only in heaven's bed. We keep it real here. Thank God for that. I told y'all, I ain't got time for those Catholic gentleman churches no more. I love them. I pray for them, but no, we keep it real in here. Now, I need Mark 5. I want you to put it on her back. I want you to hold her hand. Uh-oh. Who's the other preacher said that they don't have a problem with their period? Come on. God said, well, cover her with the other hand. Come on, the other hand. Hold that other hand. Oh boy, she gonna bleed no more. Like that. Okay, you ready? Hold the music for a second. Jesus Christ. Anything you want to say before we cast this thing and dry this thing up? Anything you want to say? No, I don't know. No, you got to talk to me. What is this thing doing to you? Come on, yeah, talk to me. Yeah, how you feel about this thing? Cut the air off for me, please. Huh?
Sometimes I feel like I can't breathe sometimes, and I don't really have the right energy.
Sometimes you feel like you can't breathe, and sometimes you don't have energy. Yeah. You too young for
sharp
that.
Sharp pains will come in sometimes.
Sharp pains inside your body. Where, your stomach?
No.
Where? In your vagina. I'm going to kill that thing. She ain't got no business having no pain in her vagina. Lying dog. In a minute, I'm going to get y'all to point her. Because we need all the power we can. I'm so angry with the devil. I'm going to do it. He just killed a 14-year-old with asthma. Tried to hurt me. And look what he's doing to her. Okay. All right. I showed you the army, right? Okay, now. She has Mach 5 on her. Okay? Now. Oh, hold on. There's a weapon for me in the armory. I wasn't even going for a weapon. God flashed a weapon in my vision. Remember how I always described the weapon to you?
Yes.
He just flashed a weapon. It's silver. It looks like, you ever seen one of them silver coffee things? So I can tell you. He told me what it was. I'm getting ready to reach up. He's going to give me this long silver thing. It's like it's aluminum, but it's long and it's silver. It's about this long. And about this right here. He said, I used it before. He said, I used it before. I just don't remember it. There was a man bleeding at the hospital. Doctors couldn't find a preacher, pastor. He was bleeding, and God gave me something to use on him because they couldn't find out where the blood was coming from, and he stopped bleeding. Okay, I'm ready. Point towards her right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm ready for that weapon. Oh, I got it. See, the weapon is silver, and it's long. He told me to tell you this so you can envision. You know what a vacuum cleaner looks like? You know what that rod looks like? On a vacuum cleaner? It's aluminum, isn't it? Silver, isn't it? It looks like that, but not as long. Okay, you got me now? Mark 5 is on you. But before that can take place, you tell me what to do. It's going inside your stomach. Because that's where the problem is. It's going inside your belly. And it's going to suck out everything that's causing you to bleed. You ready? Say Jesus.
Jesus.
That's one for the Father. Give me one for the Son.
Jesus.
Now how about one for that Holy Ghost?
Jesus.
Always in there. Now, when you get the weapon from God, just don't let, please don't just start using it all willy-nilly. He has to instruct you. He got to tell you how to use it. You have, look, doesn't everything come with directions?
Yes.
Well, these come with directions too, from him, you hear me?
Amen.
Okay, God.
Jesus.
Oh my God, guess what? This is easy. He said, don't move, just leave it there. And it's going to do the work. Here it is. He's sucking it out. Oh my God, I see it. There's blood. Lots of it. Oh, all that blood letting demon. There it is. I got it. Oh, there it is right there. So just hold it there. Everything's coming inside this tube. The tube is halfway filled. Say Jesus.
Jesus.
Halfway filled. Oh, there it is. Almost to the top. Hold on. Feel to the brim. Now what, Lord? Say, help him, Holy Ghost.
Help him, Holy Ghost.
He's giving me another tube, but this one is no longer than this. It's a shorter one.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
There's something in this one. The other one was empty. By the way, that other tube, it sucked out blood all the way to the top. But it sucked out some mass in her belly. It was a blood-letting, unclean spirit. Now, this one right here, this one he told me to put in, and he'll tell him when what to do. In the same spot, he said. Oh, there it is. Oh, my God. This one is releasing something into her belly. The antidote from heaven. It's like oil spraying out all over her body. There it is. My God. Her bleeding days are over. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bind up depression. I bind up depression. I rebuke every unclean spirit that messes with her mind, her emotions, her feelings. I bind up all pain. Uh-oh, hold on. Hold on. Oh, give me the whole world. Give me the whole world. And open your mouth. Ezekiel 36:25. Then shall I sprinkle clean water upon you, you shall be cleansed of all of your filthiness and of all your idols when I cleanse you. Swallow it. I'm going to throw this on your body, not on your face. There it is. There it is. Oh my God. Just hold it there. God said, just hold it there. Taraji, here. Give me the microphone. He said, just hold it right there. Jesus. Let me just hold it right there. Come here, Taraji. What? Talk to me.
Well, I told you before I had a period issue since December. And I actually went to the doctors, and then they said I had a polyp. And they needed to, like, insert something with a camera and scrape it. And I was, you know, skeptical about it because they were about to put me to sleep. I don't like being put to sleep for surgery. So I didn't do it, and plus they wanted to charge me $1,600. The insurance, you know, wouldn't cover it unless I paid a deductible and everything, so that was just the time for me not to do it.
Time to get healed.
And then, you know, this wasn't an alternative, but when I said I didn't want to move forward, they said I can take birth control.
No.
Making regular again, so then I remember what that's you said about taking birth.
That's
control,
a lie. So, that's one of the biggest lies I've ever seen.
And, you know, at that point, I feel like the enemy is trying to mess with my reproductive system.
We're not going to do it. Women.
And so I'm still having a little issue with it. So first it was bleeding constantly for months, for probably like a month or so, and then it just stopped, but now it's really irregular. First, I've been irregular all my life, but now it's, instead of it being more than 4 weeks apart, now it's like less than 4 weeks apart. So.
People like to play games.
Yeah.
They like to fluctuate their crap. Got you covered.
Yeah. And because of this, it seems like my immune system is down because I keep getting sick. And I haven't been getting sick before.
I
hardly ever get sick.
Now we we got you. Oh, no, we got you. Put a Bible on her for me, please. Put my file on her, too. Keep her there. Not yet. Come on. Come right here.
I went to the emergency room the other day because I'm in pain, and my pain almost all the time, but I got a high tolerance for painfuls, as much pain as I went through, but it's starting to swell up because my nerves was damaged, but he said they damaged my spinal cord to the point now where it's all that I'm always having the inflammation, and it started, is this swelling up like I'm supposed to be?
Jesus Christ.
And my tailbone, the more weight I gain, it's going to stick out, the tailbone. I've got a question.
How's that bone?
It hurts because I can feel it.
The bone hurt? Do we talk about bone, Joanne? Do we talk about bones today? In the back? Okay, hold. Hold right there. Don't you move. I'll bring you a chair for her. Okay? I don't feel too bad. I'll bring me a chair back from back there. I'll bring me that stool or whatever. She'll bring me something for herself. I'm going to kill this thing. Y'all, Pastor knew it was a miracle day. If we get all of this in here, what's sitting in a church that has 3,000 people in it? And they're not laying hands on nobody. I'm not dealing with them. I won't let them get on the mic and tell their problem. If they got 500 people and no one gets to tell that something's wrong with them, come on, y'all, that's a waste. I'm going to tell you what the man said in Italy. If a church ain't operating the supernatural power of God, it's a scandal. It's a scandal. Now, hold on. Release her. I just heard him. He said, you're done. Amen. You're healed. You're healed. It's over. It's over in Jesus' name. Jesus did this for you. You are healed. Who healed this lovely daughter?
Jesus.
Who healed this lovely daughter?
Jesus.
Then lift your hand and give him praise.
Hallelujah.
He loves you. Now go and live. Go and live. My God, my God. Go and live. Moms, the daughter's healed in Jesus' name. Say it.
My foot isn't hurt.
Say it again.
My foot is not hurting.
It was hurting.
Oh, yeah. I limped it.
You limped up here?
Amen.
She did. And the pain gone?
Gone.
Woo! Sing that song. And look what God did. Say,
I stood up here for my daughter Dolores because she's going through the same
thing. Yeah, but I want her to bring herself in here. You tell her what I said.
I will, but she's hard-headed. That evangelist, and that tell her she'll come.
That's in there, your mom? Tell her. Thank you. Thank you, Miss Grace. Come on. I don't want to be healed. Huh? How about with the polyp gone? Oh, let me have it. Point towards me. He said, call for the elders of the church. Any sick among you? Call for the elders of the church and let them do what? Anoint you with what?
Oil.
And pray the prayer of faith. And who will raise them up? Let me have a holy water. I want her to drink it. I want it to go right down in her body. I want her to drink this holy water. I'm the power of God. Hold them up. Swallow that. Say Mark 5.
Mark 5.
Come alive.
Come alive.
We're releasing Mark 5 until you right now. That's going to shut up everything in your body. Don't be long. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over your immune system. I take authority over your reproductive system. He said, whatever I bind in the earth is bound in heaven. Whatever I loose in the earth is loose in heaven. And I bind up all sickness, all disease, all afflictions, all infirmity, and I loose wholeness and wellness and healing on you right now. In the name of Jesus. Loose her, Satan. Let her body go, you lying dog. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over all sickness in this building right now. In the name of Jesus. All pain, go from here now. All hurt, all swelling, arthritis demon, loose this place. I bind you to the cross. I bind you to the blood. Female problems. I curse you with a curse from God. I curse cancer right now in Jesus' name. I curse diabetes. I curse kidney failure. I curse dementia and Alzheimer's. I curse migraines in Jesus' name. I curse kidney problems, liver problems, colon problems, pancreas problems. In the name of Jesus, I curse knee problems, back problems, joint problems. In the name of Jesus, I curse witchcraft, voodoo, hoodoo. I curse it in the name of Jesus. That's where you heal. Heal in Jesus' name right now. Heal. There's nothing left. And you won't need a deductible. It just got deducted. By the power of God. In Jesus' name. And you won't need a birth control pill. Women, the biggest lie that a doctor can tell some of y'all. If you're a woman of God, you ain't got no business taking no birth control pills. I had them in here said it. They said that I would bleed for months if I don't take this birth control pill. I said, no, you don't. They got off of them and they stopped bleeding. If you're a single woman, you're on birth control pill, something wrong. You're not as safe as you're saying you are. If you're saying and you're on birth control pill, why are you on birth control pill if you surrender to the Lord and wait on him to send you a husband? No, this is what you're doing. You got the birth control pills just in case. Just in case. One night I slip. You said, just what you did? Yeah. Oh, no. A lot of Christian women do. The church is full of single women on birth control. And they in the church. You got no business taking them. Because not be no just in case spirit on you. You said, I ain't taking them because they ain't going to do nothing. And married women, if you're taking them, get rid of them. Say it. Yeah. Now I'm going to bring them here. Now I'm going to bring them on my feet before you go to work. Trying to operate on him. How old is he? Five years old. Bring this young man to be 5 years old. Let me don't operate on no children 5 years old.
My daughter said that they said because when he sleep, he stopped breathing.
He stopped breathing?
Yeah, he
stopped. Sleep apnea?
Your tonsils.
Tonsils closed up.
That's the same thing Terrence had.
Terrence had it too. And you did too. There's too much sickness out here. Yours ruptured.
While
you were asleep.
She just so happened to check on us.
So you would die that night.
She found me in a pool of blood. My tonsils had ruptured.
Y'all heard it? Her tonsils ruptured. Mama found in a pool of blood. Rushed to the hospital. Y'all see how much sickness is out here. Every church is full of crap, messing with people. Every church, every denomination got some crap in there messing with God's people. Do you hear me? It's time to stop the crap. Jesus wants to stop the crap in us. Do you hear me? Now, you. I know, because I must be running out of battery. Father, in the name of Jesus. Point towards her for me, church. Father, in the name of Jesus. I declare healing in your body. I bind up all problems. Matter of fact, I boldly release a miracle on you right now to be made whole, woman of God. Right now. There'll be nothing wrong with your body. Every bone in your body is now healed. Every bone in your body is pain free. No more swelling in your body in the name of Jesus. I curse sickness on you with a curse from God. And I declare you totally whole. I declare you walking better, sleeping better. I declare it done for you. And I declare that your body is now blessed with the power of God. There it is. With the power of God. In the beginning was the Word. It's in you right now. Heal. The Word was God. Was with God. Was God. Heal. In the name of Jesus. Sit there. And you'll heal him for a second. Don't release your rod yet until God tells me it's done. Oh, what's his name? Jaleel. Come here. Open your mouth for me, man. It's an open ear. Swallow that for me. Say tonsils. Be healed.
Be healed.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Say no operating.
No operating.
On this child's body.
On this child's body.
Because. The great physician.
The great physician.
Is operating on him right now.
Is operating on him right now.
In the name of Jesus. Hold your throat up for me. In the name of Jesus. I declare your tonsils healed. I declare that your tonsils are exactly the way God made them. No dysfunction, no malfunction, and in Jesus' name, you are healed by the power of God. Healed. And nothing can interrupt your sleep. You are healed. Long life for you, young man. Healthy life. In Jesus' name, amen. Give God praise up in here. Done. Release it. Heal in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, here's what I'm going to do. Ushers, bye. Ushers, come on now.